reinvention, I mean, how do you see companies functioning
post-COVID? Sunita, what we have seen is, whilst many businesses have shut their doors, many people have opened their homes. And in essence, what's transpired is businesses have still continued to run at home. And we've got to look at the power of our technology in this, in the 21st century. The ability to build businesses that can still thrive from home, empowering people to still work if they want to from home. Now we've discovered in a way we never knew before that part of being pandemic proof is saying that we can still survive and thrive in a setting that allows businesses to function irrespective of where they are.
Yeah.
I have a friend who is actually right now enjoying herself in Grenada, and she is by the beach and she's working for her company here in London, and she just jolly well might have been here in the cold London weather, but nobody knows where she is. She's just working off a computer. Now, I'm not saying that that's what we all want to do, but I won't mind kind of working in Hawaii.
You need an assistant, just saying.
Oh, absolutely.
Free.
But seriously, what I'm actually saying is technology has allowed us to do amazing things as a result of what has transpired in the pandemic. Let's look at how we build on that. I think we've got to start building on that. That does mean, therefore, we might have more estate to start doing other things with, including housing.
Yeah.
Because a lot of places that were just offices are now reviewing whether they're just offices, and they're reverting back to housing. So back to a conversation we might have had
so
about
all
housing.
Those buildings become homes, and people can
Start reducing the challenge around housing and start building the areas around industry and opportunities for our citizens.
Even the entertainment industry, because a lot of people were doing concerts and things like that online, and I was thinking, like, can you imagine us all sitting in theaters side by side together again? You know, the crazy things. I mean, I was funny about this anyway, you know, that sharing a bowl of peanuts sort of situation. Those things will never come back. But to be able to sit in a theater, but guess what? A good way to sort of rebuild financially when the theaters open again, being able to still have a streamed version.
Right.
So you have ticket holders who pay to arrive and see it live, and then other people who will pay a lower price to watch the performance
that's
home
a great
on their
idea.
Device.
Theater's coming straight
everywhere.
To your home.
Yeah.
Well, that's
amazing. I mean,
amazing.
I'm just like, you know what? This can, well, you know, God always takes things that were meant for bad and turns it into something good.
I always believe that no matter how low we get, there's always a bounce back.
Mm-hmm.
And a bounce back here in the midst of where we are right now, being pandemic proof means looking at the opportunities that are disadvantaged, the disadvantage of what happened with the COVID, and start looking at how we can start building on that.
And more jobs, because less employment, maybe being able to pay people less. I know this might not be a popular idea, but being able to employ more people because you can pay less because people are able to work at home. Single parents can now work at home and still have jobs and take care of their children because they've had to do it and teach their children.
Mm.
So we've kind of like our capacities grown.
I would like
so
to see
ways.
More jobs, but also more pay.
More jobs, more pay.
Working
from home?
Working from home still. I think that we've got to start trying to empower people because people have lost jobs. People have been underpaid for too long in London. Let's that the London, you know, we've got to have a London wage that allows the poorest of us, of our communities to thrive.
Yeah.
Yet again, I want to allude to what I've often said to those who are working on our team and to those we're speaking to. We want to ensure that one mayor does not act as the answer to everything, but one mayor opens the door to everyone and everything. Mm-hmm. So what that means is you don't shut the door and say, I've got all the answers. But what you do is you're a facilitator of the best. And you bring the conversations around the table. We've got to open the door to other Londoners to be part of the future.